What if Tesla's self-driving cars started driving more boldly than humans? Would you still feel safe letting go of the wheel? Hi everyone, I'm Ken. On this channel, we don't just look at Tesla news as headlines, we analyze the meaning behind it. Because the real story isn't what Tesla did, but why they did it and what it means for the future of transportation, AI, and society. Today's episode is about something that's stirring a lot of discussion, Tesla's new full self-driving Mad Max mode, and how it connects to Elon Musk's $56 billion legal battle and the next phase of Tesla's AI journey. At first glance, those topics might sound unrelated, but when you dig deeper, they're both about one thing: Tesla's identity as a company that refuses to play it safe. Let's start with the headline. Tesla has released its most aggressive driving profile ever. The Mad Max mode inside FSD version 14.1.2. It's faster, bolder, and designed to make more frequent lane changes. This is not just a tweak. It's a signal that Tesla wants its AI to handle real-world chaos the way confident human drivers do. Ashok Eluswamy, Tesla's director of autopilot software, said this mode truly shines during daytime and heavy traffic. That means the AI is not just reacting anymore, it's making complex decisions in dense, unpredictable environments. It's learning to read the flow of traffic, anticipate human behavior, and act with judgment. Think about that for a moment. This isn't just about comfort or convenience. It's about trusting AI with risk. Because to drive like a human, especially in crowded cities, you have to take calculated risks every second. And Tesla's Mad Max mode is the first real glimpse of an AI that can do that safely. Some people might find that name, Mad Max, a little extreme, but I think it's intentional. Elon Musk has always believed that progress requires discomfort, and this mode challenges not just the AI, but us to accept that boldness and safety can coexist when guided by intelligent systems. Now, let's connect this to the other big story of the week. Elon Musk's $56 billion pay package. Tesla is making a last-ditch effort in Delaware's Supreme Court to reinstate that compensation plan, which was struck down earlier this year. Critics called it excessive. But Tesla's shareholders approved it again this year because they see it as something more than money. To them, it's a symbol, a reward for vision, not for salary. When Musk took that plan in 2018, he didn't get cash or bonuses. He got the right to earn stock options only if Tesla hit a series of nearly impossible milestones in market cap, revenue, and profitability, and he achieved them all. So, what's really at stake here isn't whether Elon Musk deserves $56 billion. It's whether a company can still reward visionaries in a world that often punishes risk. Musk's leadership style, love it or hate it, has built Tesla into an ecosystem that extends beyond cars, AI, energy, robotics, and data. And that's exactly the kind of long-term thinking Wall Street still struggles to value. At the same time, Tesla's Giga Texas just crossed 500,000 vehicles produced, a major milestone. That's not just about scale, it's about capability. Because every new vehicle Tesla builds is also a new data node in its global AI network. And that's something no other automaker can replicate right now. Analyst Gene Munster from Deepwater Asset Management said something really insightful this week. He believes legacy automakers are quietly praying that autonomous driving will fail. Why? Because if it doesn't, Tesla wins the decade. Every successful FSD update widens the moat between Tesla and everyone else, especially companies like GM, Ford, and Toyota, which are still struggling with EV margins and limited AI integration. So, While traditional automakers are trying to sell cars, Tesla is training intelligence. That's a huge distinction. Tesla's real product isn't the Model Y, it's the neural network that drives it. The company's long-term advantage lies in its data, its simulation capacity, and its AI-driven decision-making framework. Let's talk about that decision-making. Eliswamy described how Mad Max showcases Tesla's evolving ability to understand context. It doesn't just follow rules, it interprets behavior. That's the difference between an algorithm and an intelligent agent. When you think about it, that's the essence of autonomy, moving from if this, then that, to what's the best possible decision in this exact moment. That's what humans do instinctively, and what Tesla's FSD is now beginning to approximate. And here's the deeper layer. This is the foundation for the Robotaxi network Musk keeps talking about. If Tesla's AI can consistently handle unpredictable human traffic at scale, then fleets of self-driving Teslas become not just possible, but inevitable. Imagine a future where your car earns income while you sleep, and where every Tesla on the road becomes part of an intelligent swarm. From an investor's perspective, that's where the next $1 trillion valuation could come from. Because once FSD becomes fully autonomous and monetized, Tesla stops being a car company, it becomes an AI service platform. The margins shift from manufacturing to software, and that changes everything. So, what do we make of all this? Mad Max mode shows Tesla's confidence in its AI. The $56 billion lawsuit shows its commitment to bold leadership. And the 500,000 vehicle milestone in Texas proves its manufacturing machine is stronger than ever. All these pieces tell the same story. Tesla is betting its future not on safety, but on intelligence. And intelligence in the AI era means taking risks faster and learning from them quicker than anyone else. Now, this brings me to a personal reflection. I often say that the future won't belong to those who play it safe. It will belong to those who can adapt, trust, and learn at scale, whether that's humans or machines. Elon Musk understands this deeply. That's why he pushes Tesla and all of us to operate a little outside our comfort zone. So here's my question for you. When AI becomes a better driver than you, what will you do with that freedom? Will you use it to relax, to create, or to explore something new? Because that's the real promise of autonomy. Not just a car that drives itself, but a world where we can finally focus on being human again. If you found this analysis helpful, don't forget to subscribe, not for news, but for perspective. Because the future isn't something we wait for, it's something we build, one intelligent decision at a time. Before we wrap up, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I drive a Tesla Model Y, and at home, I've installed a Tesla Powerwall, so I actually charge my car with solar energy. I truly believe Tesla is shaping the future, and that's why I share the latest news and insights here on this channel. I'm from Japan, but I want to connect with Tesla fans all around the world. That's why I also create an English version of my videos. YouTube now lets you switch the audio into your own language, so you can enjoy it in whatever language you prefer. Most of all, I'd love to connect with Tesla fans everywhere so we can support Tesla together. I also share updates on X, so feel free to follow me there and let's connect. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.